Hello everybody, my name is Denis and you are watching Close to Algo Trading. Today we are going to fix one issue that you might get after installation of TensorFlow. To be more precise, just after the installation the TensorFlow will not see your physical GPU and can't use it. Well, the TensorFlow has an official instruction about how to make TensorFlow work with GPU. The latest Ubuntu version is 20.04, but we have an instruction only for 18.04. I made all these steps, except the driver installation, because I have a newer driver in my system, and I still could not make the TensorFlow see my GPUs. To fix this problem, we need to install the CUDA 10.1 from the Nvidia webpage. We need to download the CUDA 10.1 because the TensorFlow package works only with this version now. If you want to have the support of CUDA 10.2, you need to build the TensorFlow from the source. Okay, let us select the installation file and follow the installation instructions. Well, we get an error, because in our system we have GCC compiler version 9, but the CUDA 10.1 doesn't support GCC 9. We need to have GCC 8 in our system. Then we should perform the following commands before we can start the installation script again. We still have the same error. Let's check the log file and see what is there. I forgot the override flag. Very well, now I am going to install everything except the driver. After installation is completed, we need to add the path to the CUDA binaries to your path environment variables. Just put this line in your page RC file. Well, now we need to restart our Visual Studio Code to get the path variable updated. And finally, the TensorFlow can see our GPUs and can use it. Let's train a simple LSTM model to check if it really works. You can see, we have a warning that says that our network configuration will not use the CudNN. It will use generic GPU instead. Let us ignore this warning and start the training session. Phew, you see how slow the training is. But we already used two of our GPUs. Let's go to the TensorFlow help page and check what the correct parameters for LSTM layer are. So, If you want to use the CUDA, we need to use the tangent activation function. Okay, I will remove it and try to train my model again. This time, we don't have any warnings and our training is much faster. Very good. So, if you have the same issue on your machine, I hope this instruction will help you. See you in the next video. Bye!